Yesterday, somebody hacked the Associated Press's Twitter account and sent out a tweet saying that the White House had been bombed and that President Obama was injured. Not only was this false bit of information retweeted over 4,000 times, but it caused the stock market to react, and over $130 billion in value disappeared within seconds. This, of course, isn't the first time that something like this has happened. Many of you may recall that on May 6th of 2010, due to high-frequency trading, the stock market lost 1,000 points. That's over $1 trillion worth of value. Disappeared in an instant. Knight Capital, a firm who is engaged in high-frequency trading, had an algorithmic error in their high-frequency trading scheme, and it cost them $440 million in the span of 30 minutes, and it caused the firm to almost go bankrupt. It's events like these that should cause us to question the nature of the stock market. Over 90% of stocks are owned by people in the top 1%. People like Warren Buffett can manipulate global markets simply by moving some money around. So when people say they want the free market to decide, what they really mean is let the 1% decide. The stock market is really less of a market and more of a casino. It seems to me that if you're putting money into the stock market, you're just helping the rich get richer. And what's scariest of all is that these economic trends are not in any way tied to reality. I myself don't have any money in the stock market. My parents think that I'm crazy, that while working at a few different jobs where I had the ability to invest in a 401k, I chose not to. I wonder if the basis of our economy is so fragile that a fake tweet can cause $130 billion of value to vanish nearly instantly, if the people who are investing in the stock market aren't the ones who are crazy.